careful with that. There's only one of them. You're gonna break something. Oh, no. You are not wearing trainers. I want you to look like a princess.
I'm a feminist.
Party shoes now. Oh, who's got my makeup?
Hey. Look, I know it's last minute, we got everything sorted, but I got you this surprise gift. Oh. Turn around.
Oh, it's gorgeous.
You like it?
Mm-hmm. Gross!
Oi! You go and finish getting ready, you go. You, makeup.
Thank you.
So I booked these, just in case. If you're up for it, we could go tonight.
Tonight?
My mum is my friend. She's lovely and fun. She gives better cuddles than everyone.
Nice, cute.
Sometimes she shouts and makes me cry. She's so much nicer when she's with Rye. Rye? What?
That's just telling everyone that your mum makes you cry doesn't exactly scream happy wedding.
Will you try it, Harry? It's really hard. Right, nothing rhymes with Rye Rye.
It's great, honestly. Just don't really get why you've put him in the poem at all.
Because it's his wedding day. And he is about to be the stepdad, so I'm trying to be the bigger man.
Is this job dangerous?
Personal security? No. It's just following a bunch of posh clients around offering them advice, that's all. Look, they found us a house with a pool and it's near a really nice school.
But it's in America.
Look, there's nothing stopping us. Is there? Look, we can't put our lives on hold for Steve.
He has been amazing since you left. Wait, he's the one who convinced me to get back with you.
Yo, keep your noise down.
Look, all I want to do is take away the woman that I love with her two beautiful kids to this unbelievable life abroad.
Does sound like the opportunity of a lifetime.
You want us to go?
No, of course I don't. It would break me heart to see you leave. Do I think it would make you happy? Yes. Do I think it's a better life for the kids? I think it probably is.
You haven't given me any time to get my head around any of this. I can't cope, Ryan. There's a surprise wedding, moving abroad,
Okay, what are you saying?
I'm saying that I don't want to hear another word of this. Not today. Thank you.
Oh, Merce, will you come with us?
They won't want me there. I slept with the groom behind the bride's back.
Well, you know what? There's a whole forgive and forget vibe to the day. And Steve's going, and they've got a well dodgy past. Oh, please, Mercedes, I did mention that I was adopted, didn't I?
Look, we stop with that rubbish. You've known for like 24 hours. Look, I'll come, but if I don't get my bacon sarnie, I am going to puke.
Yes! Oh, thanks, Mercedes. You are the best. Oh, seriously, though. Shower first, yeah? Hiya.
Did you tell Leah that she could wear her trainers today?
No, of course I didn't.
Well, she's saying that you did and she'll not take a mask.
What?
Hmm?
Right, Leah, Michaela Barnes, get out here now. Oh! I said you could wear those, did I?
Yeah. Andy was there when you said it, weren't you?
Yeah.
Right, that is enough. You have a technology ban for lying. And you, your phone's going in the bin unless you put your party shoes on right now.
Fine.
And do not be playing us off against each other, okay? I back your mother up on everything.
Come on! Let's go.
Does that make me the worst mum?
No, having two kids cover for each other, it's normal.
Having two kids that'll not take no for an answer, who I'm always nagging at.
You are a brilliant mum. The best. You are. Right, do you know how much I love my kids? Yeah, these kind, funny, beautiful little things. I mean, it was just the other day, I was sat with our Lucas, and he goes, "Me dad, do you reckon that crocodiles will ever go into space?"
What?
Yeah. And we had a full half an hour conversation about it, talking it through, drawing little pictures, trying to work out what the little space outfits were going to look like. And all I could think about was, I couldn't love you two any more than I do right now. And that's down to you.
Me? No. Crocodiles in space sounds more like you.
No. What I'm trying to say is, We have got these happy, smart, normal kids that do still want to sit on the sofa with the dad and just chat rubbish. Even after everything I've done. And all the choices I made in the past. It could have gone so wrong, couldn't it? Yeah, I could have really messed them up.
Stay.
I am so sorry. But you know what? You're the one that saved them. You did that. And I can't thank you enough.
They are pretty special, aren't they?
So you... you are setting up all this. You're about to walk down the aisle with the man that you love and start this whole new adventure together. And I couldn't think of a better person for it to happen to. I love you, Amy Barnes.
So you may have mascara on.
Well, come here then, give us a hug.
Oh, love you too.
Me, during a wedding. Yes, fine, I'll do it. Stop begging, you're a grown woman. I love you too.
So, there's definitely about three shops that I want to try.
Who's paying for this again?
Oh, well, new little plastic friend arrived in the post today, so you can go mad as well.
I will take that. No more racking up debt until you pay me back.
You can't take his credit card off him.
Yeah.
And now it makes sense. A joint venture.
I don't know what you're talking about.
The Vashington gave my credit card. There was £200 worth of leopard print underwear on it.
Yeah. Well, I love a bit of animal print.
So does your partner in crime.
You can't prove anything.
I don't have to. I'll leave that to the police. No more spending until you pay me back. Is that clear? And technically, that is mine.
Do you need some help with those?
I'm not five.
Hey, you and me aren't gonna fall out today, are we? Not properly. Budge up. Oh, and come here.
Hey.
This mood you're in today. Is this just about the shoes? Or is it the wedding? Because you know me and Ryan, that doesn't change anything.
Then why do it? Weddings are boring.
It's because I want us to be a proper family. Oh, so, yeah, today Ryan becomes my husband, but do you know what else he becomes? Your stepdad. And he's so excited about that. Like, I might be at the front of the church telling everyone, like, how much I love Rai. But I still love you two just the same. You're my world.
Come here.
You know, when... whatever adventures we go on as a family, or even, you know, when you're all grown up and you've left home and you've fallen in love, you have your own families and you get married, you know, I am still going to be your mum. Always.
Well, I'm never getting married, so...
Yeah, well, we'll just see about that. And just so you know, I'll be right there by your side. I'll be the proudest person in the world. I'm crying my eyes out like a baby. But I'll be wearing my party shoes. So what'd you say? Mm-hmm. Yeah? Should we do this?
Yeah. Yeah.
And life is like a
one day, right?
Had a drink already, have we?
No, I'm trying to tell you that I love you.
Do you two ever stop kissing?
Well, that's what you do when you're in love, isn't it, eh? And what are you doing?
I can't dance with these stupid heels.
Well, you can take them off after you've done the speech.
You're wearing trainers.
Well, I'm an adult, aren't I? So I can do what I like. Come on, should we practice one more time?
I know what I'm doing. It's him who's going to muck it up. No, I won't!
Will!
Don't speak to your brother like that. Give each other a hug.
That's it. Pop. You know what? I've never been your biggest fan.
That's a massive understatement.
But you do love those kids. And they clearly love you.
Oh, yeah. I am the dad.
Yeah. And finally earning your right to call yourself that.
Thanks.
Just don't muck it up.
I won't.
That wasn't me.
Says the guy standing at the scene of the crime with blood on his hands. Or is that icing?
Don't worry, Steve, let's get away with anything.
I guess. Maybe.
It'll be over, didn't it?
Fingers crossed. Just, don't tell anyone.
And how are you, Leela?
Are you ever off duty?
Let me take you out for a drink one night and you'll find out.
A drink? Like a day?
Right. Come on, I'm doing my speech.
None for them.
You can't do that. You have to serve us.
I can do what I want.
That's victimisation. Prejudicial treatment. You could lose your licence for this.
You could lose your freedom for credit card fraud.
Right, come on. Calm yourselves down.
Who does he think he
time
is?
Time for the speeches.
I'm going to get me on.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I could have your attention, please. Ryan was like a son to me. I can well remember singing him off to sleep, changing his sheets when he wet the bed, and even cleaning up his vomit. And that was just his stag night. Anyway, that's the last of the funny stories from me, because I've read Leah's speech and she's got it covered. She gives Ryan a proper roasting.
Just get on with it already, old man.
Sharp tongue, that one.
See? How could we split them up?
You are a twisted, callous, bitter individual.
Well, you seem to be naming my greatest features.
Oh, and you're a total joke of a human being. It's no wonder John Paul snugged Steve behind your back.
Ladies and gentlemen, Leah and Lucas.
Steve and John Paul?
My mum is my friend. She's lovely and fun. She gives better cuddles than everyone. Sometimes she shouts and makes me cry, but she's so much nicer when she's with Rai Rai!
Hey. Is it true? You and John Paul? Don't even think about lying to me.
So take it outside, yeah?
No, I want to know the answer.
Take it from the kids.
Tell me the truth.
One night.
Tony, this is gonna kick off.
Wait, you slept with him.
I thought that you.
No, a kiss.
Don't worry, I saw it.
That is bad enough, but to sleep with your ex-husband after everything I've been through. The
crap. Steve, this isn't the time.
Stop getting you off the drugs, keeping those bratty kids in your life.
Calm down.
Yeah! Bring my hands! Hurry up! No! No one insults my kids! No!
That's enough!
It's my wedding day.
I was in one of my moods and it just kind of slipped out.
Jump on and stay.
You had no right.
It was not your secret to spill.
It wasn't him that cheated on his boyfriend.
No. He's the one who ruined the wedding. Congratulations, Scott. You messed up like you always do. You are barred from this pub, sacked from the restaurant, and I don't want to see your mincy little face around me again.
But you knew about this.
Don't worry, it's over. And you're paying for the damage. Everyone out! Party's over!
Come on, let's get you home, yeah?
Come on, son, we're not going to leave you here in this state.
Harry. Right, Harry, listen. John Paul's gone now, honey. Right, so it's not like it's a threat.
Well, that's supposed to make me feel better, is it? You're not going to have an affair because he's in a different country.
I love you.
Well, you know what, Steve? Maybe you should have thought about that before you started messing around with your ex-husband.
Oh, what's it got to do with you, Diane, eh? Nothing.
Oi! We opened up our home to you, Steve. We supported you through so much. Not just Harry's trust you've broken.
Wait, that's why you were stalling on the divorce, weren't you? You didn't want to give up on him. But and him leaving. Well, that's all to do with you.
No, it's not.
You climbed into his bed with a clear head. You knew what you were doing, what you were throwing away. It was not a mistake, it was a choice. You traded our relationship, our future, for one night with John Paul. Is that right? Right, then we are over.
If we really are leaving tonight, then we need to finish packing now. I mean, my dad can help and send the rest of the stuff out to us.
You mean it? We're going?
Yeah. What am I waiting around here for? Oh, you all said it and you were all right. Steve is a car crash. Loving the kids, Ryan. That's not enough of a reason for us to stay.
Where are we going?
Well, sweetheart. Ryan, I have been offered this really brilliant new job.
Cool. Are we going to be rich?
Not quite.
The only thing is, this job, it's not around here. So we've decided that we're going to move. To America. And we have to go tonight.
Sick! Can we go to Disneyland?
Yeah.
I'm sure we can.
What about Dad?
Oh, he's gonna come and visit, yeah.
Can I go text him now?
No. You wait, because your dad, he needs to calm down and he needs to sort things out with Harry and you know what he can get like.
Is that okay? Mm. Can we keep that little secret? Good girl.
None of this is your fault. You ain't got a mincy little face.
Yeah, but I should have kept my mouth shut, though.
Yeah, and you would have done. But that slime ball James winding you up. You know, I know exactly what to do to wipe that smile off his face.
I want a drink.
Please. Wait here. Do not finish mine, mister.
All right. Come on, don't be like that. I know it's been a bit of a crazy day. And Harry said some really silly things, didn't he? But I was just upset. He didn't mean it. And I promise you, I know I've made a huge mistake.
Again?
Again? Okay. I'll give you that. Listen, everything is going to be okay. Yeah. I mean, this is just a little blip. And I know people are going to be cross just for a little while, but then things are going to get back to normal. Yeah? Like proper normal? Come here. Now, I might have lost Harry, but at least I've still got you two. Have a nap. What is it?
We're not supposed to say.
Say what?
We're moving.
Out of Hollyoaks?
To America.
What? No, you're not. Well, you're not. You can't be.
We are tonight. Come.
Dead body.
So in case you've been living under a rock or enjoying living life to the full, base jumping or something, I thought you should know that Binky is Preggers. I know, right? Brand new Made in Chelsea, Monday at 9. And it's the return of the most dysfunctional family ever to grace the stage. Empire is back with a vengeance, Monday at 10 on E4.
Hi, Ste. Got your message. Of course you can. I'll leave a blanket on the sofa. Okay, love you. Hey, do you want to leave a message for Armstrong like that?
Oi, shut up, you.
Get yourself a little nighttime caller.